Hey there, welcome back to Clip Studio Paint Quick Tips. My name is Scott Drummond and I'm a comic artist and illustrator. Today we're going to be learning how to use the basic rulers in Clip Studio Paint. But hey, this is Quick Tips, so let's not waste any more time and jump right into it. Clip Studio Paint has a great brush engine to keep your lines stabilized. But what if you want the kind of stabilization that can only come from a ruler? Do you need to just grab one and like put it down on your drawing tablet? Well, thankfully, no. Clip Studio Paint has a bunch of great ruler tools built right in. Just click on the ruler tool icon in the toolbar. Now you can see all the different ruler types that come preloaded with Clip Studio Paint. The linear ruler is pretty simple. Just draw a line with it and your brushes will snap to the ruler when you start your brush stroke close to it. You can use the operation object tool to move the ruler around or even click on the points to change just one side. If you hold the shift key while making a ruler, it'll snap to 45 degree angles, which could be pretty handy. If you're on mobile, you can also just check this box to do the same thing. The curve ruler starts out like the linear ruler, but each time you click, you make a point in a curve. When you're finished, just double click to make the last point on the curve. Clicking on a point you made deletes that point, and you can still use the operation object tool to adjust them after you create them. Now the special rulers are where we can have some real fun. With the parallel line special ruler, we can make all our marks go in the same direction. Or we can make a concentric circle ruler, so all the marks we make follow a perfect circle around a point. I also love using the radial line ruler to create some fun burst effects that all emanate from the same point. And if at any point you want to turn off snapping for these rulers, just go to view and then uncheck snap to ruler or snap to special ruler. There's so much fun stuff you can do with rulers in Clip Studio Paint. And that's not even counting the perspective rulers, which we haven't even touched on yet. If you want to see our episode all about that, make sure to subscribe, because that episode's coming out next. Thanks so much for watching. Now get out there and make some great comics.